Beloved friends, brothers and sisters, great joy for me to welcome you all in the name of the International Sufi Movement on this very special day, also in the name of Murshid Hidayat, but he'll say something later on. This is a very special day. We always celebrate it here, and all the beautiful, special atmosphere. But this is the year that the message is 100 years ago, that was brought by our master, Abdullah Khan, to the Western world. And we are celebrating that in different meetings during this year. And the special thing about it is that it is now being celebrated by 5 different Sufi organizations, all inspired by Hazrat Dinat Khan, who are coming together in a friendly way in the Federation of the Sufi Message. We decided that this important year we should celebrate together to enjoy that company, to learn from each other, to deepen our friendship, and at the same time to let the world see on different occasions that all these Sufis are united with their different views and specialities, all united in that message. That, I think, as it should be, and as the world expects of us. And I'm very happy that after some difficulties, and long talks, painful experiences, we have come to that point of this reconciliation also with the Sufi Order International. It was difficult. There's a little stone still to put in that building that's almost finished, that still gives me some trouble and needs some patience, but it is going to happen. So at this day, or rather yesterday, on the 5th, this Urs was celebrated in Delhi by 4 of these organizations who have prepared the program together and participate in it together. I hear from Murshid Nawab Pasnak that there is a wonderful atmosphere, friendship, and celebrating this important moment together. So, we can all hope and pray that from this year on, that great message of universal Sufism is going to spread more and more widely in the world. There is progress on many fronts, but there is so much still to do. And sometimes it seems as though the world needs it, especially now. Of course, the need of the world for this message is clear already a long time from the coming of Hazrat Inayat Khan here. The world needs that message of love, harmony and beauty, of spiritual freedom, the universal message of Sufism. It is needed in so many ways, such a deep need that has to inspire again our culture, bring it together, make it into a whole. But in this year, the world is going so, I think, a very difficult and dangerous year, because somehow so many conflicts in the world are not being solved, are becoming sharper, more dangerous. The differences become cleaner. The world has grown enormously. The whole world of the Far East growing so fast and becoming a very active, powerful member of the global world, the global economy that we have. And with all the great problems that we have, caused also by our advances in science and technology, what we need to solve them is international cooperation. These conflicts have to be solved. governments have to come together. Governments have to come together with the business world, with bankers. Many problems have to be solved. But what we see is so often that they all keep to their own point of view. So what we need is that message of love, harmony, and beauty. How can that be applied? See, the first and simple thing is that everybody, all stages, all has all responsibilities. Listen to each other. Sometimes people always act to say their own view and don't notice very much what others are saying. Listen and then understand. That's what love is. Listening and understanding. That's the first thing. Then time to come together. Harmony. That the world needs more than ever now. Harmony. That the different interests, the different views which are there, all have their reasons, are brought to some reconciliation. Not the one overwhelming the other, but all getting a certain place where they fit, where the whole can go and develop. So, but on the one hand, the world seems far away from that, in a dangerous situation. On the other hand, there's this message that's going to grow, and we see that on the other hand, more and more people are open to it. As soon as we come in contact, the heart is open. They will be touched and they will follow it. We see it happening around us. We see it in so many places. We are so happy that Moshe Nawab is now working in South America, in Colombia, Ecuador, where he has already many, many murids, where there is a real need to fill. In Russia as well, many countries. But there are many more who never heard of the Sufi movement or the Sufi message at all. And still, they feel for that universality. They see that harmony is needed. That is below the surface of conflict and violence, there's a growing realization of the need for contact with the divine being, the one, however he is called, and for that love, harmony, and beauty. So we need never to be discouraged. Whatever happens, there's this growing of Sufism under the surface. And it will go on. As our master has said, you never need to worry. That message will find its own way because it is the divine message. You can trust in that. And we should keep in mind that we can contribute very much to it by our own prayers, meditations, the way we try to apply them in our day-to-day work. More and more to try every day, every hour, to have some contact with that atmosphere of the one being. In that way, we create and strengthen the vibrations that the world needs so much. So, I'm very happy that we can have this celebration together. I'm happy that Tilaru Dean from Canada has joined us, doing such wonderful work there, that we have several reads from Sufi contact celebrating with us. A sign of the growing unity in the Sufi world. Let us pray that our heart will be open, remain open, become more and more open to receive and to radiate the indescribable atmosphere of the One.